So, BoyWithUke has lore. The boy who went from playing a ukulele in his bedroom to touring Europe and the US has posted some rather cryptic videos that hint to an overarching story. So in this video, we're going to break down all the cryptic messages and themes to figure out what exactly is going on with BoyWithUke, and share some theories I have on how his next EP is going to have some of his biggest songs yet. Before we jump into the theories, let's put together everything we know about BoyWithUke. If you're watching this video, or have been subscribed to this channel, I'm assuming you already know who he is. BoyWithUke is a musician who went viral on TikTok thanks to his minute-long song series, and has since played his own live shows and festivals, even opening for AJR last year. As of January 2023, he has 3 albums released, as well as an EP and 5 singles. On quite a few of these songs, he's collaborated with other artists, including but not limited to Oliver Tree and Paufu. He's made it clear that he intends to keep collaborating with more artists, which we'll discuss more later. He also has a new single coming out on February 10th called Rockstar. Bits and pieces of this song have been released on TikTok live streams, but now the song is officially being released. Another single hopefully to be released soon is Hopeless Romantic, which has also been teased before, but now has been confirmed to be a collaboration with Marshmello by BoyWithUke himself. He also teased a new EP, which fans on Reddit have discovered thanks to leaks, to be called Gangster Vegas iOS Gameplay. He has teased other songs on live streams, but today we'll be focusing on Rockstar, Hopeless Romantic, and the new EP. And the last thing we need to know about BoyWithUke before we start is the type of music he likes to listen to. He's made it pretty clear that he enjoys early 2000s nostalgia songs like Riptide, Viva La Vida, and early Joji music by playing covers of the songs multiple times. He's also revealed that he is a huge fan of 21 Pilots. Now, 21 Pilots is an amazing band, and their work has helped inspire multiple BoyWithUke songs in multiple ways. From Tyler Joseph's fast lyric delivery, to his skills with the ukulele, the band has had an influence on BoyWithUke, so much so that he even dedicated a verse to them in Understand. I'm not lying when I said that I would rather die than go back to the times that I would try to be the guy that people know is always fighting with the demons hiding far beyond my eyelids on an island full of violence in my head, I had 2 pilots.
So that is a reference, Josh Dunn and Tyler Joseph from 21 Pilots. It's just kind of saying like, oh, I listened to 21 Pilots during this time.
Now, 21 Pilots is not your usual alternative band. Besides having some really great albums, they also have gone into the habit of tying their music together through an overarching story. I won't go into too much detail, but ever since the album Blurry Face, the band has been incorporating lore into their music, and especially in my personal favorite album, Trench. And we know BoyWithUke is still listening to their music, as he recently did a cover of one of their songs, House of Gold. All of this info is going to be important for us moving forwards. Now this is where the fun begins. BoyWithUke has joked around before on Twitch and TikTok livestreams about having lore, but they've only ever been jokes. Sometimes fans in the BoyWithUke community would joke about him having lore, calling the most simple aspects about him such as what hoodie he's wearing or what he's doing lore. However, that all changed on January 16th when he posted this TikTok. In this video, we see BoyWithUke wake up to these alarming messages, telling him that he only has 2 days left to live. Ignoring the fact that he sleeps with 2 masks on and has his ringer left on his phone, this seems to be a pretty standard tease for a music video or some other form of promotion for the song. We then see him changing through his clothes, leaving a pile of dirty hoodies and pants on the floor as he does so. Now, these clothes seem to be outfits he's worn on tour, as we see the classic blue hoodies, as well as the floral button-up shirt, which in itself may be a nod to 21 Pilots, as Tyler often wears a floral shirt when performing with an ukulele. He also throws his clothes up into the air and packs his ukulele, running past the camera with it. Now, these few shots may not seem like they have much importance when it comes to the lore. However, we'll come back to these later, as they may be more important than we think. BoyWithUke rushes out of his apartment, races to his car, and stumbles out of it, arriving at what seems to be a local park. He then plays Rockstar for the camera, bobbing his head up and down while a mysterious stalker watches from afar. So with this TikTok, we learn that BoyWithUke will die in 2 days, according to this mysterious unknown person. And as he arrives at the park, he's getting stalked by most likely the same person. He also posted a behind-the-scenes video and another tease of the song, with the second half of the video returning to the park before running off for some unknown reason. This all seems to be your normal, standard, goofy, fun promotion for the new song, but this is where the lore starts to get a bit weird. On the same day, January 16th, BoyWithUke went onto Discord to promote the new song. He then went into the general chat and posted these rather cryptic messages stating, "Be patient, my friends. The songs will never end. The videos I send will reveal themselves when the clock strikes 10. I'll see you then." Although seemingly confusing, the message basically just confirms that more videos and more songs will be posted on February 10th, confirming Rockstar's release date and hyping us up for the new song. He then jumped into the Discord's main voice channel, but stayed muted while people flooded into the call. As he stayed muted, the more people began to talk and make jokes, with someone saying they paid 5 quid for BoyWithUke to meow like a cat. A few minutes later, we got this.
That was so good.
A seemingly innocent and fun little cover of I'm Yours by Jason Mraz, just a fun little joke of a song. I recorded, edited, and posted the song, thinking of it as nothing but a fun short, and moved on with my day. A few days later, BoyWithUke started live streaming more on TikTok, playing original songs, covers, and snippets of unreleased music. During one of these live streams, during a quick break, we could hear this. Once again, he's meowing a little song. Another wholesome, fun BoyWithUke moment. But is it only just a joke? On January 24th, BoyWithUke posted a now deleted TikTok of him hyping up another unreleased song, a collaboration with Marshmello, Hopeless Romantic.
"Also, I made a song with Marshmello. Should I spend $400,000 to drop the song? Or should I be reasonable and say $400,000? I mean, seriously, the things I can do with that kind of money on my board and limited English breakfast tea and biscuits." "I'm a hopeless romantic.
The video has now been deleted on TikTok, as the fans' perception didn't go very well. Many people enjoyed the earlier versions of this song better, and their opinions were made well known on social media. However, this video ended with some cryptic messages. The video ended with subtitles on screen, which read, "Come back home, 1820 North Sheffield," I think I'm saying that right, "Sheffield, 1 through 16, timestamp 015 seconds through 020 seconds, two zeros, and meow meow." Now the words "come back home" are not used for any song's titles, however many of BoyWithUke's songs convey themes of nostalgia and wanting to escape adulthood and heartbreak. A video posted a few days after this one has a bit more detail, which we'll go over soon. The address underneath seems to be a fake one used just for the video, as I could not find any addresses based in LA that match. Believe me, I tried. I spent over 2 hours, 2 hours searching on Google Maps. I spent so long, I went on Google Maps, I tried the Chicago, Illinois house that keeps showing up on Reddit. I tried so many methods to find the house and the park that you recorded in. It took forever. I could not find that address. So please, if you know where it is, please let me. As for the timestamps 15 through 20 seconds, I believe these refer to a TikTok posted on January 16th, hence the 1 through 16 right before the timestamp. This is when we see him changing through his various outfits, including his live show clothes. I'm not exactly sure why this is here if I'm being honest, as this doesn't really reveal much of anything besides that he has a messy room. Let me know in the comments if you see anything I missed, but if not, then I believe this may be a misdirect or a red herring, and so are the meows written under the timestamps. I don't believe that cats have much of anything to do with the lore, and rather was written as a funny joke to mess with dedicated fans. Now this would have been the end of this video breaking down the lore, but as I was finishing up the script, BoyWithUke had to go and post an incredibly important video to the lore on both TikTok and Instagram. We begin the video right where the last one ended, with him playing in the park. It seems that a full day has passed, potentially he wasted a full day changing clothes, and now he suddenly receives warnings on his phone, telling him he only has one day left and giving him the address 1820 North Sheffield Drive. BoyWithUke then runs towards the new place, hopping over benches and running past a circus liquor store. This particular store is famous in LA and has been featured in countless movies and TV shows. Most likely, BoyWithUke lives in LA and shows this area as a fun place to run by during the video. He keeps on running, kicking over a traffic cone in the process until he finally stumbles upon the address. We hear a mysterious laughter as he arrives, which sounds to me like it may be BoyWithUke's own laugh that's coming from somewhere else. Perhaps there's some sick, twisted, dark version of BoyWithUke who's pulling all the strings. The stalker watches as BoyWithUke hesitates to open the door before walking in. We then are hit with a "to be continued," which I'm sure will make this video irrelevant after a few days. BoyWithUke is clearly trying to develop some type of lore reminiscent of how 21 Pilots creates a story. They often post a few songs before the new album is released, with these songs either having videos or lyrics teasing the continuing overarching story they're creating. Once the album is released, more lore is revealed and they go on tour shortly afterwards. My best guess is that BoyWithUke is trying to do the same thing, releasing a few songs before his next EP drops that tease a bit of a story. Once the EP comes out, we'll understand a bit more and potentially unravel a fun theme connecting the songs together. And hey, maybe even get an announcement of more live shows. Whatever happens, I'm sure it'll be an exciting time for BoyWithUke fans. Thanks for watching, and leave a like and subscribe for more Boy With Uke live content.